Hi students, in this video we are going to learn about the Ziegler-Natta catalyst. It is very important for the BSc MSc students and for the people who are preparing for competitive examinations also. Now, Karl Ziegler of Germany and Cilio Natta of Italy developed this catalyst, which permits polymerization of alkenes. Now we have to know what is Ziegler-Natta catalyst. It is a combination of aluminium alkyls. It is the combination of aluminium alkyls. Example, AlC2H5 thrice, that is triethyl aluminium. It is a combination of aluminium alkyls and transition metal halides. Transition metals like titanium, zirconium, like that. Example, TiCl4. Is the Ziegler-Natta catalyst is a combination of aluminium alkyls, that is example is AlC2H5 thrice, and transition metal halides, that is TiCl4, transition metal halides. Here Cl is a halide and the transition metal here is Ti, that is TiCl4, aluminium alkyls, aluminium, yeah, these are the alkyls. That's it, it is the combination of aluminium alkyls and transition metal halides. I have already said that Ziegler-Natta catalyst permits the polymerization of alkenes. Now we have to know what is polymerization of alkenes here. Here many simple alkenes give peculiar reaction when two or more alkenes molecules join together to form a new compound which are made up of several identical units. This reaction is called as polymerization. Here see this reaction. It is a alkene. It is N alkene. That means CH2 double bond CHR. It is a alkene. That means it contains a double bond. It is also called as olefin. N means it, you can consider 1, 2, 3 or 4 like that. When two or more alkenes molecules are joined together, when two or more these alkene molecules are joined together, it forms a new compound which is made up of several repeating units. Here the several repeating units are alkenes. We have only taken the alkenes. So the several repeating units becomes alkenes. Several repeating units, identical units, they are identical. Only alkene we have taken, that's why it is an identical unit. This reaction is called as polymerization. This reaction is called as polymerization. Here you can see it is a polymer. It is indicated by CH2CH in the bracket outside N. It is polymer having N units. Repeating units are present and it is a polymer and the product is called as polymer. And the singular individual or the simpler repeating units are called as monomers. A single alkene here called as monomer and the product is called as polymer. I forget to mention earlier, so I am mentioning it now. Here poly means many, meros means part. Individual molecular unit which will make a polymer is known as monomer. Here the alkene is, a single alkene is a monomer and the product is called as polymer. It is about the polymerization of alkenes. Now we can learn it by taking some of the examples. Propylene when reacted with Ziegler-Natta catalyst will give us polypropylene. It is a polymer. See here, I will write the reaction, that is 2NCH3CH double bond CH2. It is propylene, or it is also called as propene. You can take it as 2N, 3N like that. Here I have taken 2N, CH3 CH double bond CH2, Ziegler catalysts in 100 degrees Celsius and 10 atmospheric pressure. Propene is taken and Ziegler catalyst is taken under 100 degrees Celsius and 10 atm pressure. We'll obtain a polypropylene. That means here 2N CH3 CH double bond CH2, no? That's why we have to get 6 carbon atoms. That means here 1, 2, 3, 3 carbon atoms. 2N, that's why 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbon atoms should be there. It is a polypropylene. Another example is ethylene is polymerized to polyethylene. In good yield at atmospheric pressure, and room temperature by uses of this Ziegler process. And we can take the example of isoprene also. It is very very important example. Now let's take the example of isoprene. NCH2 double bond C CH3 CH double bond CH2. It is the isoprene. It is having 5 carbon atom units. It is the unsaturated hydrocarbon. When this isoprene is taken, you can see here that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon atoms are present in a single isoprene unit. It is an unsaturated hydrocarbon. When the Ziegler catalyst process is carried out in 100 degrees Celsius at 10 atmospheric pressure, we will obtain a polymer, that is CH2, CH3, CH, CH2, N. It is cis-1,4 polyisoprene. That means it is a rubber. It is a polymer. When the isoprene is taken and the Ziegler process is carried out under in 100 degrees Celsius and 10 atmospheric pressure, will obtain a cis-1,4 polyisoprene. It is a natural rubber. It is a polymer. This is also example for the polymerization of alkanes. The impact of Ziegler catalyst on polymer chemistry has been so enormous that the Ziegler and Natta were jointly awarded the Nobel Prize in 1963. They were awarded Nobel Prize in 1963. Now we have to know about atactic and isotactic polymers. What are atactic and isotactic polymers? Atactic means, here you can observe that here the side group CH3, here is a CH3 and two CH3 groups, that is attached groups, are these two groups on the upper side and this third group is on the lower side. That means they are on the irregular arrangement. Irregular arrangement is seen here. Where is in the isotactic, here you can observe that here is a CH3. Here the attached groups, that means like groups, CH3, not only CH3, we can take another any side groups. They are oriented in the space in only one plane. Here you can observe that these are oriented in only this plane, that is CH3 or only on this plane. So here is the regular arrangement is seen for a side groups. In the atactic, there is irregular arrangement, two on the upper side and third one on the lower side, whereas in the isotactic, regular arrangement is seen. That means they are arranged on the same side. It is a regular arrangement and that is irregular arrangement. These atactic polymer chains with branches are irregularly oriented bulky side groups. These irregularly oriented bulky side groups, this CH3CH3 are irregularly oriented, and if they are present with branches, these groups cannot lie on the only in the same plane due to steric reasons. So they have low crystallinity. These are amorphous, low melting point, and these are mechanically weak, that is of atactic. They have low crystallinity, they are amorphous, low melting point, and mechanically weak. Whereas isotactic, there is a regular arrangement of the side groups, so these are unbranched. Is atactic or branched. So this unbranched and the regular arrangement make them crystalline. These are not amorphous. These have high melting point and these are mechanically strong. When the polymerization is carried by radical process under high temperature and pressure, they give branched polyethylenes. They give branched polyethylenes. That means they are atactic. That means they are mechanically weak. But when the polymerization is carried by Ziegler-Natta process, we will get unbranched polyethylene. That means they are mechanically strong and they are crystalline. This is the difference between the radical process and the Ziegler-Natta process. When the polymerization is carried by the radical process, they give branched polyethylenes, but when the polymerization is carried by Ziegler-Natta process, they give unbranched polyethylenes. That means they are mechanically strong. That means they will give isotactic polymers. Whereas polymerization is carried by radical process means they give atactic polymers. That means they are mechanically weak. This is the difference between the atactic and isotactic polymers. Now the very important topic is mechanism of Ziegler-Natta polymerization. Now not much is known about the mechanism of polymerization of the catalyst. Several mechanisms have been suggested but none are so well sustained. Polymerization by this Ziegler catalyst is not either free radical or ionic types. It is not free radical or ionic type, but it is coordination polymerization. Here, how much the monomer unit adds to the growing chain is not clearly understood. In this mechanism, how much the monomer adds to the growing chain, that means polymer chain, is not clearly understood. Several mechanisms are suggested but none of them are well sustained. Here Ziegler-Natta catalyst to the combination of aluminium alkyls, that is Et3Al. It is triethyl aluminium C2H5 thrice Al and transition metal halide, that is TiCl4. It is the Ziegler catalyst. Here, the important point is triethyl aluminium. This triethyl aluminium will reduce the transition metal to lower valency state. I'll write it here, triethyl aluminium reduces the transition metal to lower valency state. Here the transition metal is Ti. This C2H5 thrice Al will reduce the transition metal to lower valency state. It is a very important point here. It will produce, this lower valency state will produce titanium trichloride. Titanium trichloride, that means TiCl3. First here or Cl4, but when the transition metal is under the lower valence state, it will have TiCl3. One Cl is less here, then it will give diethyl aluminium, that means Et2Al, C2H5 twice Al chloride. And here are three Cl's, but other Cl has come here, Et2AlCl and ethyl free radical, and one ethyl free radical, that is CH2CH3, that means C2H5. The ethyl free radical is produced. First of all, we have to see that. Please understand it carefully. Ziegler catalyst is a combination of triethyl aluminium, that is C2H5 thrice Al and TiCl4. It is a Ziegler catalyst. Here the triethyl aluminium reduces the transition metal to lower valency state. This triethyl aluminium will reduce the transition metal, that is Ti, to lower valency state. It will produce titanium trichloride. First of all, it was TiCl4, now it has become TiCl3, and it will give diethyl aluminium chloride. And the second one is diethyl aluminium chloride, that means Et2AlCl, that is C2H5 twice AlCl. And here is, first was triethyl aluminium chloride, here it has become diethyl aluminium chloride, and other ethyl will become a free radical, that is C2H5 is a free radical. It is in the lower valence state of a transition metal. It is called as, these combinations, these three, that is TiCl3, Et2AlCl and C2H5, are commonly called as active catalyst. It is also called as heterogeneous precipitate. Here this structure of Ti, I will draw it here in the active catalyst stage. Here is this free radical is attached, ethyl free radical is attached to one end, and here is the vacant site for coordination. This is the vacant site for coordination, so it is called as coordination polymerization. And the Cl's and diethyl aluminium chloride are attached around the Ti. On one side, ethyl free radical is attached, and here is a vacant site for coordination. Now we can see the mechanism. It is about the introduction for the mechanism. Now I'll explain the mechanism. It is generally accepted mechanism. I have already said Ta in the lower valence state here. At one end, ethyl free radical is attached, that is CH2CH3, and it is, this site is vacant for coordination. When the monomer is added, that is alkane is added, monomer, it is a monomer. a single alkene, that means it is a monomer, is added. It is a vacant site. Vacant site. When the monomer is added, it is the first, it is the second, it is the octahedral complex of Ti. It is the octahedral complex. Here this monomer will fit into the vacant site like this. It is the ethyl free radical. And in the next step, here you can see, in this step, this monomer is fitting in between the metal, transition metal and ethyl free radical. The monomer is fitted in between, we can use the term inserts, in between the metal and ethyl free radical. Ethyl free radical. In the next step, what happens means the monomer inserts itself between the metal and the ethyl group to form a 4-carbon chain. I will show it here. Ti. It is CH2 CH. It is a vacant site. Is CH2 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 CH3. This monomer, it fitted in between the metal and the ethyl group to form 4-carbon chains. Here is 2 carbons, whereas when the monomer is fitted, this monomer, that is CH2 CH2, will come and fit along with ethyl free radical. Now it is vacant site here. Now it again become a vacant site. Again we have to add alkene, that is monomer. Now also it fits in between the metal and the this radical. Now it will become Ti CH2 CH2 twice CH2 CH3. And this process is repeated again and again. It is the polymer we have obtained here, and the ethyl free radical is here only, ethyl free radical. See, here first we have taken a octahedral complex of Ti. Here is a vacant site and the ethyl free radical is attached. When the monomer is added, this monomer will fit in between the metal, transition metal and the ethyl free radical. It forms a 4-carbon chain. Here is only 2-carbon chain. When the monomer is added, it will become 4-carbon chain. That means this monomer, this alkene will come down and it will form 2+2, that is 4-carbon chain will be formed. And this process is again repeated by taking monomer again. Then also this monomer will come and fit, come and inserts between the metal and the free radical. Then also it becomes a carbon chain, is extending like this. This process is carried out several times and the polymerization is carried out. This metal complexes with growing chain, that means the monomer will be continuously added and the metal complex chain will be growing. This chain, the growing chain of polymer, separates from the metal probably through insertion of hydrogen. When the insertion of hydrogen is taken place, then the growing chain of polymer, this is the polymer. When again the monomer is adding, the chain will be growing like this. It is a continuous process. By insertion of the hydrogen, this polymer can be separated from the metal. This is about the mechanism and it is very, very important. We have learned the mechanism. Now we have to know applications of Ziegler Nata catalyst. High density polymers. First point is high density polymers are produced by this process. And these polymers obtained by the use of a Ziegler catalyst are superior to those obtained by the free radical process. That means polymers obtained by use of Ziegler catalysts are The polymers obtained by the use of Ziegler catalyst are superior to those of free radical process. And third point is it produces linear polymers without any branching. That means it is isotactic. I have explained already, isotactic polymers which are more dense, crystalline and high melting and mechanically strong. And the polypropylene obtained by the use of Ziegler catalysis are extensively used for the preparation of sheets, pipes, synthetic fibers, domestic articles. Polypropylene obtained by the use of Ziegler catalyst are extensively used for the preparation of sheets, pipes, synthetic fibers, domestic articles for everyday use. The copolymers of ethylene and propylene prepared by the use of Ziegler catalyst is an excellent elastomer. And the next point is the fourth point and it is the fifth point. The copolymer of ethylene and propylene prepared by the use of Ziegler catalysts is an excellent elastomer. It is the fifth point. And the last important point here is metal alkyls obtained in the process, that is heating in the presence of ethylene and nickel catalyst, gives straight chain 1 alkenes of even number carbons. Metal alkyls, I will take the example CH2, CH2, N, CH2, CH3. It is a metal alkyl heated in the presence of ethylene, that is CH2, CH2, Ni, that is nickel, heated in the presence of ethylene and nickel heated, it will give catalyst, this nickel catalyst will give straight chain 1 alkene, that is CH2, CH, CH2, CH, N-1, CH2, CH3. It is straight chain 1 alkene with even number of carbon atoms. Even number of carbon atoms are used. These alkenes are used for the manufacture of detergents. These alkenes obtained are used for the manufacture of detergents. These are the important applications of Ziegler-Natta catalyst. Now we have to know about the limitations. So it does not work for some monomers, products like polyvinyl chloride cannot be generated by this catalyst. And other example is acrylates. These monomers cannot be generated by this Ziegler and Natta catalyst. This is the limitation of this catalyst. That means polyvinyl chloride and acrylates cannot be generated by this Ziegler and Natta catalyst. This is the explanation about the Ziegler-Natta catalyst, definition, mechanism, applications and limitations. Please subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.